crocifisse con Cristo, uomo con Maria, apostole dell'Eucaristia.
The transforming encounter with the crucified Jesus and the Eucharist prompted Madre Maria Pia to found a new religious family, the Crucified Sisters Adorers of the Eucharist.
Sister Maria Pia of the Cross, in secular life, Maddalena Notari, was born in Caprilia, Salerno, Italy on the 2nd of December, 1847. Her aspiration towards a religious life was not accepted well by her family. However, after periods of trials and experiences with the Alcantarin sisters, the cloistral Byzantine and the Theresian, on the 22nd of February 1873, she received the religious habit of the Third Order of the Servants of Mary, adopting the name Maria Pia della Croce, or Maria Pia of the Cross. She chose the name Maria Pia of the Cross, which was for her the meaning and value of her whole life. She deepened the desire to belong to Christ, contemplated in the Eucharist, associated with Him as a victim of expiation for the sins of human beings. The Venerable Mother was born at the time when there were lots of turmoil in the society, when there was a lukewarmness in the faith brought about by the heresies and persecution against religion.
October 13, 1883, after receiving Jesus in the Holy Eucharist, she felt a strong inspiration which was directing her to found a religious institute. Finally, on October 21, 1885, at the age of 38 years old, Sister Mary of the Cross left her family and began the foundation of the new religious family. She lived at Bico Maiorani in Naples together with two other ladies, Adelina Bagaglio in religious life, Sister Juliana del Santissimo Sacramento, and Grazia Sarno in religious, Sister Maria Bonfilio del Calvario. The religious name reflected the program of the new foundation. The cross and the Eucharist are two realities in the life of Jesus that have strong impact in the spiritual life of the foundress, Maria Pia of the Cross. The congregation was initially named Serviti Adorers, out of her devotion to the Sorrowful Mother. This was revised later into Crucify Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament by the advice of Cardinal Guglielmo Sanfelice, the Archbishop of Naples. The constitution of the congregation, lovingly done within the year's time under the supervision and counsel of the good cardinal. The church in the person of Pope Leo XIII recognized the fruits of the active presence of the Holy Spirit by giving the Decretum Laudis, the degree of praise, on November 21, 1899, which formally established the existence of the congregation in the Archdiocese of Naples. On May 6, 1902, the same Pope approved the new institute and its relative constitution ad tempos for a definite time, while slightly changing its name, Crucified Adorers of Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. The definitive approval was on the 10th of February 1915 by Pope Benedict XV. In 1978 General Chapter, the name of the congregation was modified and became Crucified Adorers of the Eucharist, according to the norms of the Second Vatican Council.
Almost 20 years had passed since the inspiration was received by Madre Maria Pia. The time had come to open new houses and begin new forms of apostolate, even though already in 1894, the first house is at San Giorgio a Cremano, Naples, and declared to be the Mother House, and the second house had been opened in Castel San Giorgio in the province and diocese of Salerno. There were 8 houses founded by the Mother during her life in Italy from 1819 to 1921. From 1922 up to 2019, there are 16 houses founded after the death of the Mother. This include all the community in the mission area. Generous souls of sisters had gradually joined the Mother. Pia understood that it was also necessary to respond to the demand of the ecclesial and social problem of the time, especially those victims of war. Thus, she decided that boarding schools for girls, nursing homes, and embroidery schools should be established. On the 1st of July, 1919, Sister Mary of the Cross returned to our Heavenly Father at San Giorgio Cremano. Her words of inspiration and her life example remind the sister to embrace the cross, embrace the sufferings for the love of Jesus and Savior.
My daughters, my body is leaving you, but my soul will stay behind to be with you. I recommend you to be faithful to the Institute, obedient to the Constitution. Do not take for granted the Eucharistic adoration, because it is the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament who will help you. Be charitable and love one another, a love that is rooted from the charity of Christ.
The mother wanted us to understand her spiritual program.
I must be holy because the God to whom I belong is holy. I must look to my Savior Jesus as model to imitate faithfully day by day. I must always progress in my holiness without ever looking back.
The process of her beatification and canonization was opened on April 13, 1921. After many years of the process of the fame of holiness of Madre Maria Pia of the Cross, the decree of heroic virtue was promulgated by the Holy Father Pope Francis, and she is now worthy of our veneration, the Venerable Madre Maria Pia of the Cross. Last July 1, 2019, we celebrated the first centennial of her death. The decree of plenary indulgences was granted from the Holy See for all those who venerated the mother in all the chapels of the community of the sisters throughout the world. The first exploration for the mission in 1984, a year of preparation for the centennial celebration of the congregation, 1885 and 1985. The mission was opened in the Philippines, and by the encouragement of the Salesian and the Order of the Franciscan Conventual Fathers. The first missionaries, under the leadership of the late Mother Juliana Pormisano, were Sister Josepa Camilio, Sister Floriana De Rosa, and the late Sister Daniela Naka. The sisters set forth for the first time on January 3, 1984. And on January 14, 1984, the sisters, accompanied by Father Antonio Barbangelo, RCJ, had their first audience with the late Cardinal Sin, who joyfully gave his paternal blessing. June the same year, in the occasion of Corpus Domini, the community established for the first time the Eucharistic office. This realized the greatest desires of the Mother Foundress, assuring the validity of the Eucharistic sacrifice. Due to the increase of vocation in the Philippines, the novitiate was established in 1994. Aware that the importance of education will be a great help and for evangelization, the congregation opened a school named after the foundress, Madre Maria Pia Notary School. It was solemnly blessed by the late Jaime Cardinal Sin on March 13, 1988 in Paranaque. The congregation expanded in southern part in the province of Davao. A new house, school, named after the foundress, was opened in Barakatan Turil, Davao City. During the General Chapter Extraordinary, with the election of the new Mother General, in the person of Madre Floriana de Rosa, paved the way for the mission in Indonesia. It was in the year 2000, the Jubilee year, led by Sister Gabriela Tornatore, they started the mission with the invitation of the Franciscan Fathers. Vocation from that mission sprouted, and the Indonesian sister is now in the place of origin for the mission. In the year 2016, through the invitation of former Bishop of Panitan Capiz, now His Excellency Jose F. Cardinal Abimbola, presently the new Archbishop of Manila, the mission was opened in that place with Sister Mary Ann Liang and other two sisters assisting and guiding the youth in the parochial school.